Here at Mount St Thomas Public School, the teacher, Jennifer Faulconbridge, has taken a unique approach to giving students the opportunity to develop digital solutions. And today they have got some very special visitors to showcase their solution to. Let's go and meet the teacher now and find out how she started her STEM Share journey.
So the principal booked the tablet robotics kit, which we were really excited to get a hold of because it has things for early stage one, stage two and stage three. So what we did is we decided on a model where we would use the kit for learning, to leverage learning for the kids, but also to do professional learning for the staff. So we have a couple of teachers on staff who are really nerdy. And so they were team teaching with the other teachers the units of work that they're going to be using. So we met with our staff to talk about the learning that was going to occur this term and what sort of things that they wanted the children to demonstrate understanding of. And then we anchored the tablet robotics kit in the learning that was already going to occur in the classroom. So stage one did a literature study on Willy Wonka, and they did really cute things like getting Dash to roll Violet Beauregard down to get squeezed in the juicer. Stage two did a unit of work on how technology can keep us safe, because we had a PDHPE focus for this term. And stage three, we're doing a unit of work on gold. So we did mining equipment and making sure Dash didn't die a horrible death on the gold fields. So that's how we sort of anchored the learning within whatever we were going to be doing already in our classes. We worked mostly out of the library because it gave us a nice big clear space, and it meant we had more area for the kids to spread out, so that, because they're all lying all over the floor and all sorts of things, and in classrooms that can be a little bit challenging because they can be a little bit little, but also we were really mindful of not losing too much Lego. So we thought it was best to have all of the equipment in one place, accessible for the people who needed it, and we had charging stations set up in the strong room in the library. So everything was either being used or on charge all of the time, so whenever you went to use it, you knew it was going to be ready to be used. So we followed the scaffold that's on the learning library, which has the mini challenges set up, and the first mini challenge is always get to know the gear. So we watched your videos and we got the equipment out, and we gave them some really simple open-ended tasks with each piece of the equipment. So learning how to connect the Lego WeDo block and all of those kinds of things, so that they knew how to use it without actually leveraging the learning at that point. We just wanted them to know how to use the stuff. So we basically gave them a session with each piece of the equipment that they were going to use for the duration of the unit of work that they were going to do, and let them have a play with it. And they said, basically, have a go, because you can't break it. Okay, so here is where all the programming is. All of those do something. Off you go. Go have a play, see what the things do. And then after about 10-15 minutes, when they all were going, you have all these ooh-ah gosh noises happening all over the library because they found that they could do something. They would run from one group to the other, I found it did this, you have a look at this, and they would show each other how to do things. And I brought them all back to the beginning and said, okay, so now you know how kind of to use it. I want you to use this, and I want you to use that, and I want you to use this and see what it does. So I gave them a vague scaffold of what I wanted them to do, so that I knew that I was hitting the markers of getting it to move, getting it to make a noise, getting it to stop for a particular stimulus or something like that, so that they had a few tools in their tool belt for the next time they came to the unit and we were going to be doing something with the actual content they'd done in class. And we also used it as a really handy assessment, because what we did is they learnt the content in class, and when you're in class, they can spit back at you the things that they think you want them to know. And then I gave them a scenario over here. So for our safety unit, we had one where they were doing road safety. So you had to do something with road safety, what was going to be involved. And they had to use the information that they'd learned in class to create a scenario for the Lego WeDo to make a safe vehicle that people wouldn't get injured by. So they did motion sensors so that they would stop, and they did tilt sensors so that if it went over a bump it would stop, and things like that. So that then they were able to, as we roamed around, so there was me and another teacher, we were observing and taking notes and asking the kids questions so that they could explain their process of how they made it, but also how the content from class was being exhibited by what they'd made. So there was an expectation that they would include information that was part of the core curriculum, as part of using the robots, not just building a fun, shiny thing.
He's telling the public like what's going on, so he goes there and he introduces himself, but you can't really hear it because it's a bit noisy. And then he comes here and he sells the weather, says that the weather's going to be like, there's going to be a flood. And then he goes here and he says the flood's here, and then he goes up back up here and he gives advice. So.
Tree and he said that he's brave and he climbed it and he got stuck and scared, and then he was shouting for help but no one was in the park except him, and he was like brave and he got down,
climbed down,
and the message is that always be brave and never give up.
Within each group of students you'll have the kids who are really tech savvy, who pick up things really quickly. And they're the ones who will play with all of the obscure code that all of the other kids won't want to look at. But then when the other children want to do a part of a design that they can't get to work, they're the kids they'll go to. And you don't have to be the solution to everything. And often if they want to do something really tricky, you can just Google the thing and there'll be someone who's done it who can help you find it. But it is scary standing in front of a whole class of kids and not being the one to know all of the answers. But it's a really powerful thing to say to the kids, I really don't know. Let's go have a look and problem solving it together. But the ability to try things more than once and the expectation that it will not work the first time and that we will have to work on it over and over and over again is really powerful, and it builds a lot of resilience and persistence as well, which sometimes is lacking. We used ours for maths, we used it for PDHPE, we used it for history, and we used it for English. So we used all of the science outcomes are still being covered. So they're still doing the coding, they're still doing design, but they're using it not just in a science setting. So they're able to see that those skills and strategies are applicable across domains, not just in one field. For us, because we've been doing the technology can keep us safe, we've got the SES. And last lesson, they had to design an SES vehicle that would help in the case of a disaster. So they brainstormed all of the things that they knew the SES had some sort of a role in completing, and then what they did is they designed a robot that would fulfill one of those tasks. And they had to make sure that their robot sort of moved and that it used a motion sensor, so making sure that they embedded all of those coding skills in it, but also having it for a purposeful reason, not just because Mrs. Faulconbridge says I have to do it.
I heard, or we heard, that you'd been making some awesome, cool things with robots that would help the SES, am I right? Excellent. So we wanted to come down and maybe have a look at some of those things that you've made in a minute, but what I wanted to do is show you some of the cool things that we've got so that we can come and see probably what is even cooler, the things that you've made. Pass it to them so they can put it on, or they can pass a rope and then they can pull them in with the rope. It goes really, really big. It goes to 3 stories high, so it's also got a really long reach. It's quite heavy when it's that long, so it'll take 2 people to hold it.
There will be adults walking around the room having a look at your design. They can't stay there for an hour because there are 60 other kids that need feedback. Is that fair? So you get to ask maybe one, maybe two questions if you're super, super lucky, and then you can work on your design with the feedback that they have given you when they move on to the next person.
What about when people are driving? What do you think? And there's a lot of water around. What do you think our main message is?
So here we've got a very detailed vertical rescue. So what happens is, if somebody's fallen down the side of the cliff, the guys have created a machine that we can lower down off the side of the cliff, rescue the person and then pull it up. And what happens is when it gets to the top, there's a special sensor that knows that it's reached all the way up to the top of the cliff, so they can help rescue the person nice and quickly. I think it's brilliant. Well done, boys.
It's easier for the SES to tell us how to be safe rather than our teacher, because the SES have a personal experience.
Yeah, and it's like real life, so that's kind of cool too.
So we've had a really interesting afternoon here with the kids. They've had some really, really good ideas with their robots on how they can help the SES and how the SES can help the community.
I thought the community messaging that some of the kids had as well was phenomenal. They had some really great ideas, really intuitive thoughts around how to use Dash, and putting the message out. The fact that they knew the message as well already was great.
At our school, every time someone that gives us something special like this, we do something special back. It is called 10 heads, 10 hearts, and 10 claps. It is for the heads is we'll remember what you have done. The claps is like thank you, and the hearts is where we loved what you have done.
What a great example of community engagement here at Mount St Thomas Public School. If you're interested in anything to do with STEM Share, please reach out to us. You can find us on Twitter, Facebook, and of course, Department of Education Yammer.